This is a continuation of the solutions to the intermediate algebra practice problems for midterm 1 at MiraCosta. We're starting with number 7 in this video. Solve and check. 7 over 5x minus 7 tenths equals 7 over 2x. Now, this is an equation. That means we're solving and trying to find out what x is. So we could use the properties of equations, multiply, add, subtract, or divide the same thing to both sides of the equation. First thing I notice is I have fractions. So one of the easiest ways to get rid of fractions when you have an equation is to multiply both sides by the least common denominator. So I look at the denominators and it's going to be 10x because I have a 5x, a 10, and a 2x. If you want to factor the 10 to see 2 times 5, that might help you see it. So what I'm going to do is multiply both sides by 10x. So I'm going to multiply the left-hand side of the equation and the right-hand side of the equation by 10x. And I need to do the distributive property here on the left so that I have 10x times 7 over 5x minus 10x times 7 over 10. And on the right-hand side, I don't have the distributive property, so I can go ahead and just cancel. The x's cancel, right? And then 2 goes into 10 5 times, so I have 5 times 7. So the right-hand side is just going to be 5 times 7, or 35. And now on the left side, we do our canceling. Again, the x's cancel. 5 goes into 10 twice, so that's going to give you 14. 2 times 7 is going to be 14. Minus, and let's see, next one, 10x times 7 over 10, the 10's cancel, so I have 7x equals 35. All right, so now I have an equation without fractions. All right, back to the drawing board. How do we solve this? Well, there are various ways to do it. I'm going to subtract 14 from both sides, so that I have the variables on the left side and constants on the right. Be careful though, that's not 7x, that's negative 7x. And then 35 minus 14 is 21. Lastly, I want to divide by negative 7 on both sides to solve for x. So we hope that's it. It's very important to check your work because it's easy to make a mistake. So what we're going to do is take the original problem, plug in negative 3 for x, and see if both sides of the equation are the same number after simplifying. So we're going to check to see when I plug in negative 3 if both sides are the same. All right, so I'm going to plug in negative 3 everywhere there's an x. And then I'm going to simplify the left-hand side of the equation. So I have 7 over negative 15, so that's negative 7 fifteenths minus 7 tenths. Now I have to get a common denominator, and that would be 30. So if I make them both 30ths, let's say I'd have to multiply the first fraction by 2 over 2, so that'll be a negative 14. And the second fraction by 3 over 3, that's 21. So I have negative 14 minus 21 is negative 35 thirtieths. And then that reduces. I could divide top and bottom by 5, so negative 7 sixths. So that's the left side. There's no solving equations here. You're simply plugging in the number and simplifying. Now we're going to do the right-hand side. I'm going to plug in negative 3, and I have 7 over negative 6, which is negative 7 sixths. So yes, indeed, it checked. So therefore, the answer really is negative 3. You know, checking it actually might be harder than doing the problem over, but that's the only way you're sure you got the right answer. All right, here's the next problem, number 8. 15 over x minus 4 equals x plus 4 over x. Now, we could do the same thing here. Multiply both sides by the least common denominator, which will be an x times an x minus 4. Or, because this is a proportion, it has one single fraction equaling another single fraction, I can do cross multiplication. It means you could multiply those two together, and it's the same as when I multiply those two things together. So I'm going to do it that way. So I have x minus 4 times x plus 4 is equal to 15 times x. All right, so we've gotten rid of the fractions this way, and you would have exactly the same thing if you multiply both sides by x times x minus 4. It's a little shortcut. Only works if you have one fraction equaling another fraction. Okay, so now how am I going to simplify this? Well, it's an equation, but in an equation, first you need to simplify both sides. So we need to FOIL on the left, x minus 4 times x plus 4. Oh, that's going to be a difference of two squares, x squared minus 16. Equals 15x. And then I have a quadratic because I have the x squared, so I need to set the equation equal to 0 by subtracting 15x from both sides. So finally, I factor. Let's see, it's going to be 16 and 1 minus and plus, so that gives you the correct factors, and again, you could do the factoring on scratch paper. So I have x minus 16 equals 0 or x plus 1 equals 0. So either x is 16 or x equals negative 1. Now, we want to check to make sure both of these is really the right answer. So we're going to check it back in the original problem up here. So the original problem was 15 over x minus 4 equals x plus 4 over x. Remember? That was the original problem right here. All right, so we have to check each solution separately. All right, so first let's check 16. We're going to put in 16 for x. So I've got 15 over 16 minus 4, which is 15 twelfths. And then you reduce, divide the top and bottom by 3. That'll be 5 fourths. Now let's do the right-hand side. You're going to put in 16 for x, so 16 plus 4 over 16 is 20 sixteenths, and then I need to divide top and bottom by 4, which is 5 fourths. So that checks, so 16 is a solution. Now we're going to check negative 1. That was the other solution. So we're going to plug in negative 1 for x, negative 1 minus 4, so that's 15 over negative 5, which is negative 3. And on the right-hand side, we're going to plug in negative 1 for x. And that gives me 3 over negative 1. And 3 divided by negative 1 is negative 3. So that checks. So these solutions up here both checked. So those were the correct solutions. So 16 and negative 1 are correct, each of those solutions. Note, that's not an ordered pair. Those are two different solutions to the problem.